What's up, guys? Riccardo Ammendolia here. I just want to say thank you to subscribing to my YouTube channel. And if you haven't subscribed, please do so when you can. You just hit the little button below there. It means so much to me. Guys, today I want to talk about what everyone's talking about, ADCC 2019 and ADCC in general. I think right now it's one of the biggest topics of discussion in the grappling world. And, you know, one of the biggest questions I get asked a lot and what I see online is, how do you get invited to ADCC? So today I want to talk about that process, and here are my five tips on how to get invited to ADCC. And you know, it's 2019, we're at September, we're 25 days away from the big show. No one's really going to be able to take these tips or these five suggestions and get invited, but maybe you never know in the last second, who knows. But at the end of the day, this is, you know, to help people understand the policies and kind of what goes on at ADCC, and also maybe for those in the future that are aspiring to be an ADCC champion, you could take some of this advice and use it for your career. So, number one way of getting an invite to ADCC is you need to be the current ADCC world champion. If you are a champion from 2017, you're going to be invited automatically. You get the first slot in the 16-man bracket to fight in ADCC. So guys like Cobrinha, JT Torres, Gordon Ryan, Buchecha, Felipe Pena, Bia Mesquita, Gabby Garcia already got their slots. They're already invited. They were the first people invited. It's not even like an invite. They're just automatically qualified to compete at ADCC. Once you're invited, not a lot of people have declined invitations. Some maybe if they're doing mixed martial arts. Recently, Rubens Cobrinha Charles actually declined just because, you know, he wants to open up a path for his son Kennedy Maciel to compete, which is really cool. But for the most part, a lot of the guys invited will be there. A lot of the champions from 2017 will be returning to defend their title. The only difference, of course, Felipe Pena, who is the open weight champion, will be competing against Andre Galvao in the super fight and for the super fight title championship. So that's pretty much, you know, the basic. The first way is you become an ADCC champion, you get invited to the next year's ADCC World Championship. Number two, you win the trials. You are a trial winner. There's a group of trials worldwide held by different promotions, everywhere from Japan to Brazil, United States. I think there's an Australian trial. So if you win the trial, you automatically get a spot. You get the second spot in the division to get into the ADCC. You know, the trials have been some of the best competitions. That's how we've been able to really scout some of the new names that maybe we're not so familiar with in the big show. And, you know, you see everyone from guys like JT or Nicky Ryan, Gary Tonin, you name it. Guys have kind of come up and you know, cut their teeth, so to speak, at the trials, getting used to the format of ADCC with a little bit of a modified time length, but that's really the second way how to get in. So you win the trials, you're in. Some trials locations gets two spots, some gets one. This year was the first time they gave Brazil or South America one trial for whatever reason. A lot of the other ones got two, such as Europe and North America. Now, again, you win the trials, there's no dispute, you're in. You're automatically entered, and all you got to do is train and get ready for the big show. Number three, the third most common way people get invited, and when I speak about this third one, this is not a guarantee, but this is definitely giving you more of a chance to get invited than not. So if you're a former champion of ADCC, let's say from 2015 or the past, if you're really a fan favorite or, you know, you just performed amazingly, there's a good chance you might get an invite. You know, guys like Claudio Calazans comes to mind, you know, a guy who fought at the open weight division, won the open. He didn't even win the super fight last ADCC, but he ended up getting an invite replacing Homo Bahal, who was another guy that won ADCC back in 2013. So, I mean, it's not always the guarantee for being a former ADCC champion, but it definitely helps your case getting invited. So the first two criteria are guarantees, and the next three criteria are more like, you know, helpful ways to get you in. They're not guarantees, but they definitely help your case. Number four, I like to call this the alternate. And basically what I'm referring to is the guy that went to the trials, whatever trials it was, and put on a show, had an amazing performance, but maybe got second. We've seen this happen where people have gone, maybe even got third. They put on amazing performances at the trials, and you know, maybe at the last minute or the week before the show, you know, somebody in the division gets, or somebody in the division pulls out or has to withdraw. And you know what? We've seen trial performances help people get invited to ADCC. So my point is, instead of just petitioning online and crying and making fun of, you know, or telling the world how much better you are of the guys that get invited, go to the trials. If you're not the defending champion, if you're not a champion from before, go to the trials. You know, guys have been going to the trials like Barry Yoshida for many, many years, and they've been competing all the way from 1999. So that's really the second best way, or sorry, the third best way, how to really show the ADCC committee on how good you are. It's one thing to, you know, send them YouTube links or tell them how amazing you are at other competition circuits, but they really base a lot of their decisions on who shows up to the trials, how well they perform, or who is a champion. Number five. Number five, again, it's not a guarantee, but it's one of those, you know, sort of gray areas where we found in the past that the MMA star or the needle mover gets invited to ADCC. So who am I talking about? I'm talking about guys like Dylan Danis, guys like Ben Askren, guys like Milton Vieira in the past, you know, guys that didn't really win, you know, ADCC trials or maybe, you know, huge no-gi competitions at the highest level of black belt. But they're huge needle movers, whether it be through wrestling, whether it be through mixed martial arts, they move the needle. And when I talk about needle movers, I'm talking about they have a fan base that transcends through grappling. And it's not just the grappling and jiu-jitsu guys that are in the gi that are fans of theirs, but maybe it's wrestlers, maybe it's MMA, you know, MMA fans that will, you know, want to see what's going on in ADCC because of these needle movers that have been invited. So again, you know, you look at a guy like Dylan Danis, one of the most talked about competitors, super tough, black belt under Marcelo Garcia, even though he's not on his team anymore, but he's legit, you know, and a guy that brings a lot of eyeballs to the event. Even like a guy like AJ Angazarm was invited, got silver at the last ADCC, hadn't competed in any competition, got invited, but, you know, he ended up pulling out to go to have an MMA fight. But again, he is a needle mover, whether you love him or hate him. These guys move the needle. They get people talking. They get interest. They talk about the event, and that's another important thing. So they bring a lot of eyes to the event, and that's another reason why guys that are needle movers get invited. So today, guys, I hope this sheds some light on to how people get invited to ADCC. It's obviously a little bit of a tricky process. There's five layers of it to like I described, and you know, hopefully this, you know, gives it a better understanding for those aspiring athletes who one day want to compete at the highest level, which is ADCC. We all know that that's the pinnacle of the sport. And, you know, even if you're not looking to compete, maybe you understand a little bit more of the selection process for the upcoming event. And I hope to see you guys there. Hope you guys watch the show. It's going to be amazing. There's only a few live gate tickets left. But if you can't go see it live in Anaheim, you can watch it live on flowgrappling.com. I'll see you guys there. I'll be part of the broadcast team as well as a whole team of experts. It's going to be awesome. I'll see you guys live from Anaheim on September, what's the date? 28th and 29th. See you guys September 28th, 29th, live from Anaheim ADCC World Championship.